A most unusual visit, I should say.
One we are most certainly equipped to handle.
Your Highness, Bloom of Duna, Flame of the
Queen Justinia sucks in her cheeks, then offers you her unwavering hand. The Queen retracts her hand and rewards your reverence with a curt nod.
An audience is granted. I am yet too intrigued to give my leave. Now tell me, Isbiel, why do you allow the Crimson Prince before me?
My queen, the scaled specimen before you is a godwoken, a claimant to the divine throne.
The queen wrinkles her face and gives Isbiel a sideways glance. Isbiel's red-brown eyes meet her gaze.
Many have laid claim to Lucian's legacy, including his own inferior spawn. I presume our visitor has more than a vague title to boast of.
He has escaped the island prison to which the Order confined him.
A refugee from the Joy, then. Impressive. Few avoid the Magister's watchful eyes. Can this Godwoken declare other triumphs, Isbiel?
Isbiel returns to her reek.
The Godwoken arrogated the Lady Vengeance. The very vessel that terrorized the high seas under the Hammer's command.
The Queen's eyes grow wide, and she nods appreciatively, then looks to Isbiel to continue the ovations.
The Godwoken has slain his very own, Alexander, son of...
Indeed. Slayed by your hand, then. The cub once pleaded with me to aid in his sorcerer pogrom. I cannot deplore your actions, as loath as I am to admit it.
The great sorcerer Riker, a lone wolf known for his manipulation of the innocent dead, died by our visitor's hand, Your Majesty.
I do not know of this Riker. I trust his death was well deserved.
Our venerated guest has brought hope to the elven tribes by ending the slaughter of their ancestors.
So you eliminated the butcher responsible, I presume. You have earned your swagger.
I am consort to Her Royal Highness Justinia. It is my business to know who serves the Queen's allies and abets her enemies. Lizard royalty does not roam this land unnoticed.
Now, let us continue.
My Queen, the Godwoken hobbled the Black Ring by slicing off one of its limbs. A necromancer known as the Salome.
Isbiel's hot stare burns into your soul. You meet her gaze with one of your own, though you know you could never match her intent.
Splendid. The Black Ring has proven a chaotic element at a time when control is imperative. I'm overawed, truly.
Such an excellent question, but a bit premature, don't you think? We adhere to a certain decorum in this court. I am sure you understand, my prince. Goodness. I've met street urchins with more manners. I'd think lizard royalty would have more respect for ceremony. Well, I see no reason to mince words, Godwoken. You're here to die.
Isbiel, whatever's gotten into you? Malodorous it may be, but this is still a court, not a gallows.
Your Majesty, the Godwoken is no ally, but enemy. He would throw your plans in disarray. You have worked so hard. Arcs must fall to the death fog.
What? Nonsense, Prince. It cannot be.
Oh, but you're a clever one, Godwoken, aren't you? Fine. You've outed me. But it doesn't matter. You can't stop the death fog. The wheels are in motion.
Isbiel?
Shut your royal maw, Justinia.
Arcs will fall and your memory writ. They will believe it was your will, your plan, your command.
For a moment, Isbael appears almost relaxed. Her eyes flash blue, her face quick.
Isbael?
My queen, forgive me, I...
Isbael screams in pain and clutches her head. She bobs and sways, muttering to herself. You can make out few words, but you recognize the language. It is the Eternal Tongue.
The covenant will be kept. I serve you with living and dying breath, my king. Glory be to...
You blink yourself awake to the cold gaze of a thousand stones and the hot gaze of the dwarf Isbael, right hand...
Oh, good. You're awake.
At first, I figured I'd just kill you. But then I thought, Isbael, you're wasting an opportunity here. Don't bother thanking me just yet, though. I dare say you'll be begging to die before long. So I'll start with lesser toxins, just to see how you react, and take it from there.
How strong a dose can a godwoken handle? How long does it take for one to succumb? So many questions.
Your lips open, but no words spill forth. You try to lift your head, but it is no match for gravity. She has paralyzed you. Only your eyes have...
Don't fight it. You'll only make things worse.
Oh, but I've been so rude. You should know the real me.
Oh, it's good to give myself a rest. Those masks can be darned pesky, can't they, my Marifol friend?
Every ounce of energy within you evaporates. You have no more control over your own source.
Do try to relax. Oh, that dose proves quite alarming for my normal subjects. I'd forgotten that you are... Well, let's see now.
You struggle to move.
Move on to...
Isbael turns the valve, but no fog wafts forth. In that moment, you...
What's wrong with the... Guard! Come!
Get out of this death trap.
Thank you. left your companions in shock. Black Ring influence or not, the enormity of the Queen's plan is revealed to kill everyone in the city.
So, to prevent a war, she goes to war. I'm not sure I'd buy that logic.
It's a preemptive attack. Queen Justinia pursues victory with cunning. I might do the same.
Spotted something.
Thank you.
show yourself.
Isbeel! The traitor! Where is she? I will split her black skull in two!
By whose hand?
Yours? It should have been my own axe to slice her neck. Take me to her bones. I've a mind to chop them into pieces, the foul...
Justinia struggles to control her rage. She closes her eyes. She is
dead. And that is that.
She was a scientist of sorts, or so the town criers chanted. She knew of the ways of nature and beyond, and I invited her to court to show. She healed the sick and soothed the wounded. I saw it with my own eyes. I brought her close. Her words were wise, and her aims, well, they seemed so pure.
It was after Alexander assembled the quorum that Isbeel turned my mind to thoughts of war. Our scouts and spies aided dwarven sorcerers where and when they could, but Isbeel insisted the monks and shriekers would touch dwarven land.
When we came to Arx to prepare, she rarely left my side except to tend to her laboratory. I'd no idea what atrocities she'd been committing there.
Justinia pounds a fist against her palm.
You may not believe me, but what I did, I thought... Power always comes at a great cost. Sometimes you have to take some lives to save others. And I shall always put dwarven lives first. You must understand this.
It was only a matter of time, she said. And I never doubted it. The scouts talked of living weapons nailed to crosses, of blank-faced wizards, an entire force of them. If we didn't come for the Order, the Magisters and Paladins, they would come for us. They had my ear all the while. The Black Ring. I'm sorry. Truly sorry. To think of it.
Bless his heart. Please do tell him to rest his mind. But do be sure to keep my whereabouts private. At least for now. My concerns in Arx must remain my own. It closes in, then. It's so much more dangerous than even death fog. Death fog we can see and smell. The void is empty, intangible. We don't know it's there until its creatures are upon us. Kem? Linda Kem? All the better that he's avoiding Paulina like the porcine plague, then. The Kem estate is the only safe haven remaining for me in this burning city. This black ring rot has infected the very soil we tread and the air we breathe. So unless you...
The Queen is now free of the Black Ring's thrall. Leave her be.
Only a coward or an imbecile would invite Ispiel into her court. Either way, she deserves to die.
Ross asked us to keep her safe. I don't see why we should...
The Queen nods a goodbye to you.
Until I can return to the kingdom, I will be at the chemist.
A humble builder. When your source powers surfaced, you knew you were in for the joy. But you ended up here, stolen from your cell. They took you apart in search of your source. You died.
I spotted something. Planted in the royal court quite some time ago. This conspiracy has been a long time brewing.
The shade of a spirit shimmers before you. A sorcerer, a dissolute dwarf with a big mouth, you were thrown in the slammer. Fort Joy beckoned, but you woke up hooded, being dragged through the sewers to a painful end. You never saw the light again.
Is safe at my death. I've faced the grave before, you know, as have you. Yet through the God King, I have eternal life. The Master's purpose is his own to speak, not mine.
With words so sincere, I almost believe. Let's pretend I fell for your little persuasion game. I'll tell you the Black Ring's plans on one condition. You release the Death Fog. You bring my mission to an end.
The spirit pauses, then nods.
The God King feeds on war, on death, on disease. On the rich, the Death Fog was not just a murder bomb, but a tool. A tool for sowing discord. A tool for pitting the Order against the Dwarven Kingdom. A tool for ridding us of those who would see us fail. Every race, every creed, and every claimant to the title of divine.
Isbel's voice rises, and her fists tighten. You presume she'd have got.
I lived for that day.
The spirit's eyes and mouth narrow. In her silence, the noise of splashing sewer water bounces from the stony walls and into your ears. lit Isbael's fire. She is a bomb, a banshee, an erupting volcano.
You couldn't know! You weren't there! When the portal opened and the Death Fog poured in, you weren't there! Have you ever felt your own saliva sizzle? Have you ever felt your own brain hinder? I was given a chance. I made a decision. One that I have never regretted. It is time then.
Sits before you. Pipework, tentacles out, even through the seals of the great cistern. You scent the acrid sting of the death fog inside. A faint gossamer of death fog rises from a junction where the release valve meets a pipe. A switch allows redirection to a different pipe, labeled C. The junction currently leads to a pipe labeled Arx.
That other pipe leads to the C. Redirect the flow. It'll minimize the harm.
The only way to keep Arx safe is to smash this thing to pieces. Do it!
Redirect the death fog. Better to poison the fishes than to poison the people.
The machine creaks to life, and the death fog begins. You hear the howl of the fog as it travels the pipe towards the sea, and the machine winds down. The cistern is empty. All is silent.